The suit says the mayor called the lawyers vulgar names before another profanity-laced tirade, saying, quote, "My blank is bigger than yours and the Italians. I have the biggest blank in Chicago."
From a hot man to one of the hottest women in the business right now, Megan Fox with me now. Why do you shake your head?
Because I'm pretty sure I'm a doppelganger for Alan Alda.
Oh, God, out of here.
I'm a tranny. I'm a man.
You do not look in the mirror and not think you're beautiful. Don't even.
No, I'm so painfully insecure. Like, I'm on the verge of vomiting right now. I'm so horrified that I'm here and embarrassed. I'm scared.
Is this your first time here?
Yeah, it's my first time.
I love you're watching the monitor. You're looking at Selma Hayek going, God, look how gorgeous she is. Have you looked at yourself lately?
I really want her boobs. Those are the most amazing boobs. Perfect.
You want her boobs, I want your boobs. Yeah, we're all even.
All right, we'll trace.
Is your man Brian Austin Green here tonight?
He's not. He doesn't want to be here. You know, he doesn't want to be my date. He's a man. He has an ego.
So no. He's watching, maybe.
I think he's probably working on music. I don't think he cares.
Really? You don't think he's watching you right now?
No.
What is your diet and exercise regimen? Because I have to ask you, because your body is smoking.
Well, I do have a 22-inch waist. I will say that. But I basically starved myself for a month. I'm kidding. I did a lot of Pilates.
You do.
An immense amount of Pilates.
I love it. You're an honest woman. Thank you so much, Megan, for stopping by. Good luck with everything.
Everybody knows that you're a very attractive woman, but tell us, what would surprise people about Jessica Alba?
I'm a man.
My mom said to me, you know, sweetheart, one day you should settle down and marry a rich man. And I said, Mom, I am a rich man.
There was that rumor word that you had a male appendage, that you were a hermaphrodite, and you joked about it on the stage last night.
Maybe I do.
but it's interesting.
Would it be so terrible?
But it's interesting. A lot of artists would immediately put out some sort of a statement saying this is absolutely not true. You have fun with it.
Why the hell am I going to waste my time and give a press release about whether or not I have a penis? My fans don't care, and neither do I.
The truth is that I am artificial and attention-seeking. I devoted myself so strongly to my music that I forgot about my family. Every bit of me is artificial and attention-seeking. I aspire to try to be a teacher to my young fans who feel just like I felt when I was younger.
Which was?
Artificial and attention-seeking. I had this dream. And I really wanted to be artificial.
At one point, when you were performing, some of the customers did something you didn't like. And you did what?
Something just came over me and I took my clothes off.
You took all your clothes off?
Not all of them. I left my bra and underwear on.
You take your clothes off a lot.
I do.
Is it your desire to shock? Because what you do is considered shock art.
I am attention seeking.
You know, there also is this strange rumor that you're part man, part woman. You've heard that rumor.
Yes.
True?
Certainly.
What is the essence of what you want the world to know about
Stephanie? That I'm really a man.
Like Beyonce, who is definitely pregnant. No questions asked. Until now.
There are actually a lot of people that believe this rumor. And it's crazy. I guess there are some crazy celebrities in the world, so we get a bad rep. But to think that I would be that vain, there's certain things that you just shouldn't play around with. And a child, you don't play around with that.
Sofia Vergara has a man jaw. Sofia Vergara, has anyone checked for a penis? These are from the internet.
For sure bigger than yours.
No.
How can you feel? Like I get to play a sold out show at SoFi Stadium tonight for the first time in my life.
A girl? guess what I'm trying to say is you're making me feel like I'm a man.
Girl. And how does it work when a person of your caliber has her head shaved? You pay a hairstylist like $400 to do it?
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, something like that.
I didn't think about it until it started, like, oh, what is the shape of my head gonna look like?
Right.
Because that was really, and then I started to, I really started to panic. I was like, if this is not, you know, and then Sia was like, I know it's gonna be round. I know it. And it all of a sudden was like a birthing. It was like, it's a boy. It was
like, you probably don't remember me. But we go back a long way. Actually, I've known Lucille Ball, man and boy, for over 20 years. And during that time...
I mean, it is what it is. I feel like a gay man sometimes in a woman's body. I sometimes love getting dressed up and looking like a fabulous drag queen.
We had, in the very first episode that Ashton was in, there was a point at which he was supposed to drop trow and be completely naked in front of me.
Yeah.
And we didn't know how to do that in front of the live studio audience without him actually being naked, because right. The whole point was it was supposed to shock people. And we said, well, so we're going to have to cover him up somehow, but it still has to be shocking. And everybody was trying to, you know, people were going, working this over in the writer's room. And then Ashton pipes in, oh, well, I've got a huge prosthetic penis in my trailer.
What?
And we all sort of, we all had that awkward moment of, of course you do.
Yeah.
But what it was
everyone?
Exactly.
Sometimes you got to prop the door open.
Yeah.
Exactly. So, but it turns out it was a flesh colored
colored prosthetic penis.
But no, with
anatomical full midsection.
Correct. Yeah, it was a full midsection, yes. With very impressive anatomically correct.
Listen,
member.
They only had one guy that was willing to be the mold.
Yeah. Yes. Wait, this is a midsection and a very realistic.
It's
so the thing
Rita's,
is realistic.
It's a midsection.
My question is two. Why did you have this, and where do I get one? Those are my questions.
You too can have one made.
Okay.
Throughout my career, I was always asked to describe my dream role. And it was clear to me that I wanted to portray a strong and independent woman, a real one. The irony in this is that later, I was cast as Wonder Woman. And all of these qualities I looked for, I found in her. Wonder Woman also struggles with her own love and hopes. She gets confused, insecure, and she's not perfect. And that's what makes her real. We wanted her to be universal, to be an inspiration to all people all around the world. And our plan was to make sure we didn't give too much attention to the fact that she's a woman. Patty just shared an anecdote with me, and she said that someone told her that his three-year-old saw the movie, and when the movie ended, the boy said, "When I grow up, I want to be a woman."
Johnny Depp's one of the great character actors of our time, I believe. Trapped in a leading man's body, he's got the best of both worlds.
Those who think young.
Mr. Powers, look, there's Britney Spears drinking a Pepsi.
Oops, I did it again.
That's not a Pepsi. It's a Pepsi Twist Man. And that's not Britney Spears. It's a man, baby.
Austin, it's me!
Rhyme on this wig! Come!
Fair enough.
Pepsi.
Which takes us to Marlin's Island, the island of Teddy Roe, this gorgeous island. He bought an archipelago. He bought nine islands for $250,000 when he did Mutiny on the Bounty, this paradise. And the next day we get there, he weighs like 500 pounds. His hair is blonde because he just did a movie which he dyed his hair. And we're flying in, we see this, and Mike, the producer, says, "Who is that woman, that enormous woman on the beach?" I said, "That's him."
Oscar is the most beloved and respected man in Hollywood, and there's a very good reason why. Just look at him. Keeps his hands where you can see them. Never says a rude word. And most importantly, no penis at all. He is literally a statue of limitations. And that's the kind of men we need more of in this town.
So I peed standing up out of a funnel.
A shiwi.
Yeah.
I've burst into her bathroom with a BB gun while she was trying to pee
he
in her funnel.
He pelted me while I'm like, it's so hard to do because you have to stop while you're in the middle of peeing to let the rest of it go out. Like, that's a whole scientific process. I'm like, I'm trying really hard. I'm like, there's a lot going on. And then he burst in and started pelting me.
What's wrong with you? Listen, between the pair of us, that is some serious, serious hair.
That was a lot of hair.
At least you can tell what gender you are by your voice. I can't stand hearing my voice. I'm like, no. I'm also a wildly bad actor.
That's terrifying.
That was like, I find
God, is this what a vagina looks like?
No, look at this.
Hey, guys. Sorry.
Lactated from your nipples. And all of them wrote back.
Dude.
If I was in the X-Men, that would be my superpower. Mammary man.
No, it doesn't even matter if we say we are.
Yeah, what, I don't see what this has to do with anything.
idea was like, we want real people. So they, you know, they like got, I don't know, we were like on a beach and then they threw us a football and they're like, play football. And all the other models were like, playing football like in a pretty way, you know, like, and not me. I was all of the photos. I've got a red face, covered in sweat. My nostrils are flared. I'm like, no.
During our sex scene, I felt your dick rubbing into me.
And that is Jennifer Lawrence and Chris Pratt. Playing on insults. That was the darkest one yet. Bye.
Like, I don't always turn into this masculine alter ego that like jumps into shark ridden waters just to make my friends laugh. My friends were like, that's like too far, Jen. Like, no.
Jessica Simpson, if you'd played a game of touch football with her Saturday night and you were going to play another game with her after the game on Sunday, would it, as Terrell Owens has said, have distracted you so much that your performance on the field might have been bad? Would that really have distracted you?
No. No. Absolutely not. Besides, she's got man face.
She's got what?
She's got a man face. George. Looks like a truck driver. Give her a flat top and a mustache, a pair of engineer boots and a black leather jacket. Man, you'd be scared of her.
The eggnog cookies has kicked in.
She's a man.
He's lying. Shut up!
History has certainly shown that even the most intuitive criminal investigator can be wrong from time to time. But if I am mistaken, if the lieutenant is indeed a woman, as she claims to be, then, my friend, she is suffering from the worst case of hemorrhoids I have ever seen! That's why Roger Padactor is dead! He found Captain Winky!
And she was like, yeah, I look like a boy with long hair. And I made a PowerPoint presentation for her. And in that presentation were androgynous rock stars.
People are kind of obsessed with you and your lovely wife, Olivia Wilde. But she's a different species.
Oh, it's a different thing. Yeah. Bone structure,
yeah,
skin.
Yeah, totally. I'm surprised you can, like, breed.
Teeth, eyes color, like, literally just about everything. I think, I would say my penis is better. I'll go on record saying I have a better penis than her.
Mm-hmm. I bet you $5.
You know what? You're probably right.
I bet you $5, you're wrong.
We're probably tied at best. At best, we're tied.
Christmas. Yeah. Any chance of coming down to the land of Oz again?
Yeah, we're thinking about it, you know. What we're doing this year, though, is we're kind of taking it a little bit easier because we're pregnant.
Yeah.
I'm pregnant too, you know, and I've got to take it easy. But,
Now, what happened?
I think most people thought that I would be the first one to have a solo album and then the band would, you know, Queen would break up and all that. But here you are, after 13 years, four old poor old ladies are still rocking away.
Look, I don't know exactly what kind of actress you're looking for in this role, but I was thinking if a guy was going to change his sex and wanted to be like a movie star type of girl, don't you think he might want to look like me? Performing Demi Lovato, and Danica is here as well. Hello, how are we doing?
I'm doing great, and I'm excited to have Danica Rome here with me.
So how did you guys connect?
We connected because I heard her story. She's actually the first out and seated transgender state legislator in American history. And when I heard that, I was just completely inspired by it. And I wanted to have her in the audience with me tonight because I feel like we've been through some of the same things.
Let's see who you are. I take off your disguise and flip.
Oh.
You flipped too hard, damn it!
All right, shifting gears to Jennifer Lopez. You're gonna like this one. She's in the middle of shooting a new video for the song Follow the Leader, and since there are a couple of action scenes in it, well, they hired a stunt double. Here's a picture right there. It's a man. He looks a lot like J-Lo, doesn't he? Similar bone structure in the face, skin tone very much the same. But they did put padding in front and, of course, in the back because J-Lo, known for that big old booty. Look at that.
I was gonna say,
can they find a woman to perhaps...
I know there are female stunt doubles out there, but...
Fly. Forgive me, Papa.
That to satisfy herself inside, she pretended to be a man outside.
Hello.
Hello.
So that all the things she wanted to be, he could be.
I'm a student.
In other words, I think the closest character I've ever played to who I really am would be Anshul in Yentl.
How close? Close in spirit? Close mm-hmm. in heart?
Everywhere. See, I didn't, in other words, I wasn't acting a part. Do you know?
Well, as long as we're on the topic of big announcements, I have something to tell you all. I'm a dude. Well, you certainly date like one. I'm not joking. I'm a dude. I've been hiding my candy from you for the last 6 years.
Are you saying that you're a
tranny?
Wait, you're
a drag queen, a Shanghai surprise, a plum smuggler. You're a private dick.
Okay, we get it.
A weenie in a bottle.
I thought you had breast cancer.
Well, I did have a lump, but it turns out it was a third testicle. I'm fine.
I got hand cream.
Wait a minute. Yeah, this keeps my hands hydrated. You guys believe in hydrating, don't you?
Feel those hands. Sir, just feel this part right here.
Do they feel like a woman's hands?
Yes. They feel better than a woman's hands. Hey, when you're alone in the woods for 4 years, it's nice to have a pair of women's hands handy.
You want to keep the package within your power zone.
All right.
My package is in my power zone.
So, what you just put me through my paces today, I just urinated.
Women want to be with me, men want to be on top of me. Women want to be with me, men want to be in me. No. It's the way that this goes. So they can't.
Drank a lot of NyQuil. A lot of NyQuil. And woke up with my pants around my ankles in an alley.
Did you feel better?
I felt better. Sort of the guy I was with.
I was absolutely a boy for about 2 years of my childhood. And
really?
And the Beast!
The first acting award in history that doesn't separate nominees based on their sex says something about how we... about how we perceive the human experience. This is very meaningful to me.
You think Prince rides pretty tall in the saddle? What do you think? Think he's sporting it? Big one? Think he pleases the ladies?
I'd say he's got horse goods down there.
I don't know. Any guy that wears more makeup than his girlfriend, though. I don't know. Whatever yanks your crank, I guess.